and he grabbed the beard of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And so Uthman said to him, لو رأى أبوك مقامك مني لساءه. If your father was to see the position of you right now with me, then he would have disappointed him. And so that made Muhammad Abu Bakr go back and let go of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And whilst that took place, the two Egyptian men came into the house and they tried to stab Uthman radiallahu anhu, but his wife went in the way and she tried to stop and they cut her fingers off. And so after doing so, they went to Uthman radiallahu anhu and they stabbed him. And the blood of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu is spilt on the verse in the Quran while he was reading that was still open. It fell on the verse. فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا. Up until he reached the line, فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will suffice you from them. They dropped, his blood dropped on this verse. And that is how Uthman radiallahu anhu was killed, Maqtal Uthman. And so then they dispersed. And the wife of Uthman radiallahu anha, she went out of the house at the front, where the rest of the Sahab were guarding. Because they came from another direction, where Al-Hassan and Hussein and the other companions were not guarding. And so she went and she told them, and everyone came and they saw the dead body of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And the father, Ali, the father of Hassan Hussein, Ali, came and he struck his children. Didn't I tell you to look after him? And all of the Sahaba that sent their grown up children all beat their children because they did not safeguard him properly in their eyes. And so that is the Maqtal of Uthman. And a lot of things took place after that. A lot of things took place. But the main thing here is Ali radiallahu anhu was made the next Khalifa after Uthman radiallahu anhu, after that event. And Muhammad ibn Bakr was involved at the beginning stages of this event, the Maqtal of Uthman. He later went on to make Tawbah. And when Ali radiallahu anhu questioned him, he first questioned the wife of Uthman. When Ali radiallahu anhu questioned the wife of Uthman, she said, I did not recognize two of the men, but I recognized Muhammad ibn Abu Bakr. And so they went to Muhammad and they asked him, why did you do so? He said, I had the intent of doing such a thing, but then he reminded me of my father and that caused me to step back and to not be involved. And so he said, I did not kill him and I was not involved in holding him to kill him. And she said, the wife of Uthman, she said, but he's the one that let them in. He's the one that let those two men in. And he said, it's true, but I have made Tawbah and I've turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance. And those two men, they made off. Those two men, they made off. And a lot of khilaf took place after this. Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, who was the family member of Uthman, wanted to capture the killers before he makes and pledges his allegiance to Ali. And Ali radiallahu anhu said, we are going to catch them, but let the affairs settle down, because there was a lot of them in the city at that moment. And so he said, let the pledging of allegiance take place and let the things calm down. And once we have strength, then we go after them. And this khilaf, this different, led onto other things to take place. It's not that Muawiyah radiallahu anhu wanted to be Khalifa or wanted to be ruler or the likes of these things that some of the innovators spread, but it was rather the fact that they had a disagreement on which one should they choose do first. Should they capture the killers first, or should they pledge allegiance? Muawiyah and the people in Sham, should they pledge allegiance first? And that was the Khilaf, Mansha al-Khilaf, not like other people tried to make it out of. And so in short, that was the Maqtal of Uthman radiallahu anhu. May Allah be pleased with him. And this was mistaqan لِلْقَوْلِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. He testified to the truth of the statement of the Prophet ﷺ when he prophesied and pre-told him that he was going to enter Jannah by a trial and a calamity that's going to take place to him. And that calamity was that he was going to be killed. And that a group of people want to take the khilafah off him. And that khilafah, the metaphor the Prophet ﷺ gave, was a shirt. And so do not take off that shirt for them. And that's what Uthman radiallahu anhu did. And Uthman knew that he was going to be killed, so he did not want his Sahaba to go out and fight against these people and to spill the blood of the Sahaba to get rid of them. And so for that reason, that's why Uthman took his position. And as for the person that Uthman was trying to protect, his family member, then Marwan and whoever was with him, they left Medina after that and they went to Sham. And so that is the end of the Muqtala of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And then we go on to Ba'adhu Maqalati, some of his statements. Wait, Ba'adhu Maqalati, some of his statements. We'll round off with this, inshallah. From his statements is that he said, هم الدنيا ظلمة في القلب وهم الآخرة نور في القلب. That for a person to worry and to think about the dunya, it is darkness in the heart. And for a person to think about and to worry about the akhirah, then it is nur, light in one's heart. Likewise, from statements is من ترك الدنيا أحبه الله ومن ترك الذنوب أحبته الملائكة وأحبه المسلمون. Whoever leaves alone the dunya, then Allah Azza wa Jalla will love him. And whoever leaves alone sins, then the angels will love him. And the believers, the Muslims, will love him. He likewise said, أَرْبَعَةٌ ظَاهِرُهُنَّ فَضِيلَةٌ وَبَاطِنُهُنَّ فَرِيضَةٌ. Four affairs, outwardly it is a virtue, and inwardly it is obligatory. And they are, أولا مخالطة الصالحين فضيلة, that to mix with the righteous people is a virtue, والاقتداء بهم فريضة, and to take them as an example and to follow them in that righteousness is obligatory. Secondly, وتلاوة القرآن فضيلة والعمل به فريضة, that to recite the Qur'an is a virtue. There is many great rewards in reciting the Qur'an alone. وَالْعَمَلُ بِهِ, acting upon it is obligatory. Thirdly, زِيَارَةُ الْقُبُورِ فَضِيلَةٌ وَالْإِسْتِدَادُ لَهَا فَرِيضَةٌ, that to visit the graves is a virtue. It reminds you of death. It's not something obligatory, it's a virtue. The Prophet ﷺ says, it reminds you of death, so visit the graves for the men. وَالْإِسْتِعْدَادُ لَهُ, and to prepare oneself for it, and to prepare righteous deeds when you go to the grave, is obligatory. There's no choice about that. Likewise, he said, وَجَدْتُ حَلَاوَةَ الْعِبَادَ فِي أَرْبَعَةِ أَشْيَاءَ. I found the sweetness of worship in four things. أَوَّلُهَا فِي أَدَاءِ فَرَائِذِ اللَّهِ. Firstly, in fulfilling the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those things that are obligatory upon me. وَالثَّانِي فِي اجْتِنَابِ مَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ. Secondly, in staying away from those things that are haram. وَالثَّالِثُ فِي الْأَمْرِ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ ابْتِغَاءَ ثَوَابِ اللَّهِ. Thirdly, to command with good. الْأَمْرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, seeking the reward of Allah. To command with good, to tell someone it's time to pray, let's go pray. Let's fast 3 days every month. This is min al-halawa in the worship. Seeking the face of Allah. And lastly, النهي عن المنكر اتقاء غضب الله. To warn and to forbid against evil whilst fearing the punishment of Allah. So in these four things, there's halawa to ibadah. وبهذا نختم, and we allow our brother to continue with the fourth, the last khalifa, رضي الله عنه جميعا. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.